I used this image to create a cartoon effect in Photoshop. This is the awesome result, so let me show you how to do it. Hey guys, I'm Chris, and the first step is to get rid of the background behind the model because I will apply the cartoon effect only on her. I will press W to activate the object selection tool, and then I will choose Select Subject. This should be a very simple selection in this case. However, if you want to have a perfect selection, you may need to grab the lasso tool, for example, and add to the selection holding down Shift. Let's take care of the hair very quickly. It should be very simple. I just press on Select and Mask. From View, I choose Overlay. Then I choose the Refine Edge Brush and paint over the edges of the hair to refine the selection. When I'm done with this, I choose New Layer with Layer Mask from the output and then click OK. And now let's create the custom background. I add a gradient adjustment layer, double-click the gradient to change the colors. I will choose a darker blue here. Make sure the opacity is at 100, and then choose a lighter blue for this part of the gradient. From this list, I choose radial, then 90 degrees for the angle and 155 for the scale. Check this detail option to avoid heavy banding on the gradient. Move the center of the gradient just a bit to the right and then press OK. Now I drag this layer below the model and I have a cool background. Awesome! Now comes the fun part. Make sure you watch each step until the end. I press Ctrl-J to duplicate the layer with the model just to make sure I have a backup of this. In fact, let me just rename this to backup. Just drag it down here, make a group with the original image pressing Ctrl+G and hide the group. This is optional, by the way, to keep the workspace cleaner. I renamed this layer to Model and this one to Background. To start creating the cartoon effect, I'm going to turn this layer into a smart object because I will add different types of filters stacked up. The first smart filter that I need to apply is from the filter gallery and it's called Poster Edges. From here, I will enter 3 for the edge thickness, 1 for edge intensity, and 2 for posterization. This effect creates some thicker outlines for the model. You can play with these settings and see what works for you because every image is different. For example, if I would choose 1 for posterization, the image will look like this, and I don't like it, so I will stick with 2 and I'm gonna click OK. The next step is to go to Filter, Stylize, and from here I will add the oil paint filter effect. I will use 5 for stylization, 3 for cleanliness, 0.1 for the scale, and 0 for the bristle detail. Make sure the lighting box is unchecked and then just press OK. Now I go to Filter, Sharpen, Unsharp Mask. I will choose 100 for the amount, 6 for the radius, and 20 for the threshold. By adding this effect, you can see that the eyes became more sharp, but also other edges too from the hair were close. You can see the difference if you check and uncheck this preview option here, and then you can click OK. We finished an important step, but there is more to do, so let's dive deeper. But first, can I ask you to press the like on this video? Thanks a lot. So the next step is to select the layer with the model and duplicate it with Ctrl+J. Then I go here on the right side of the smart filters, right click and choose clear smart filters. That's because here I will add different filters, but this layer will have a lower opacity. This is why I duplicated this layer. Now let me show you something. I will go to Filter, Filter Gallery, and this time I will choose the Cutout Filter from the Artistic group. I set the number of levels to 5, Edge Simplicity to 0, and Edge Fidelity to 1. But there's a problem right now. Her skin has these blue tones, and this is not what I want. If I click OK and check a before and after, you can see the blue tones on her skin. So how do I solve this? I make the image a bit warmer. I go to Filter and choose Camera Raw Filter. From here, I go to Basic and I enter 20 for the temperature, making the whole image warmer. I click OK and now I will drag this Camera Raw filter under the Cutout filter. I want Photoshop to first warm up the image and then apply the second filter. So let's double click the second filter now, and as you can see, the blue tones disappeared because I warmed up the image with a filter below this one. And now all I want to do is to lower the opacity of the layer until I feel it looks right to me. 50% looks awesome. Here's a before, here is the after. It looks great, but if I look at her hands, I can see some blue tones there. I want to hide the effects from this layer on the hands. So I click on the smart filter layer mask. I take the brush with the B on the keyboard. I make sure the foreground color is black. Opacity is at 100 and flow at 20%, and I paint over the hands to hide the effects on those parts and bring back the orange tones in the skin. Now I want to add a hue saturation layer on top, and with this little hand, I want to target the skin only, okay? So I click once on the skin, and now if I drag this slider, I will affect her skin saturation. 30 looks fine to me. Here's a before and after if you want to see a difference, and let's move forward and add some grain to this image, because it will make it even cooler than now, trust me. So I go to layer, new, layer, or press Ctrl Shift plus N. Let's name it grain, keep the opacity at 100, choose overlay from here, and then make sure you check this box, fill with overlay neutral color 50% gray. Now, because this layer is an overlay and it's 50% gray, it's invisible. So I'm gonna use this layer to add grain. So right click, convert to smart object, and then filter, blur gallery, and choose filled blur. You can just drag this point out here to see the image better, then use 100 for the amount, 50 for the size and roughness, 0 for the color, and 50% for the highlights. This means that the grain will be more visible in the shadows area and less visible in the highlights. Click OK, and I hope you can see the grain at this point because YouTube uses compression on the video. But what I want to do now is to lower the opacity of this grain layer, so I will keep it at 30%. Let's add some contrast to this image by creating a curves layer, raising up the highlights just a bit, and bringing down the shadows just a bit. A very subtle effect that I recommend. Now, to make this image really pop, this is what you can do. Make sure the top layer is selected and create a stamp visible layer pressing Ctrl, Shift, Alt, and E. Now I want to desaturate it, so I press Ctrl, Shift, plus U and put this layer on overlay blending mode. I know it looks weird at the moment, but I'm not finished yet. So the next step is to duplicate this layer with Ctrl plus J, put this one on linear light blending mode, and hide it for the moment. I select this one, and I go to filter, other, high pass. Enter 20 for the radius, and click OK. Now if you hide and unhide this layer, you can see that the image looks much more contrasty and more awesome. I will unhide the top layer, and use it to sharpen this image even more. So again, filter, other, high pass, and for the radius, I will go down to 1 pixel and hit OK. Now when I zoom in and then check a before and after, you can see that the image looks way more sharper than before. And you can lower the opacity like I do now. And for me, 70% will do just fine. So that's the final result. Make sure you share this tutorial. And if you like this video, I'm sure you'll love another one from the screen. Meanwhile, look how we started and we achieved this amazing cartoon effect in Photoshop. So thanks a lot for watching. Until the end, I'm Chris and see you in the next video.